Hey everyone, welcome to Success Competitive Study Circle, where your dream meets goal. Let me introduce about myself. I am Deepa, faculty in Narayan IAS Academy, Hyderabad, Sankaran IAS Study Circle, Hyderabad, and Success IAS Study Circle. Till the last video, the three videos which I have done in my channel, I have dealt with the India Yearbook first chapter, that is about the national symbols. It's very important. I have told you many times. I think I need not tell you again and again. So from here onwards, what I'll be doing is we will be in our channel. We will be covering the multiple choice questions. Exams are quite near to you. So it's very important that you have to have the knowledge how to solve the options which has been given in the question, multiple choice questions. So the topics like current affairs, India yearbook, schemes, all these will be covered under this particular channel. So whatever the doubts are there, please do comment and then just to share your ideas where you are actually finding the difficulty. Let's work together by thinking in the right way and making simple things. Okay, so as I told you before, there are four options will be there, like 1, 2, 3, 4, A, B, C, D. So in them, actually among them, which is the best solution or which is the best answer, that you have to do it on the elimination method. Or if you know it very well, factual questions like current affairs and the India yearbook questions, factual questions, GK questions, static GK questions, it's very easy for you to analyze that. Okay, so as I told you, the topics are like all these we are going to cover. Minimum 10 questions are less than that one we will be covering in the each video. The reason is we have to cover a lot many informations, not only one question and just the options, three options. But the rest of the options which is given, which is very close to the option which has been given, so that will be explained. Okay, the concepts will be cleared for you. So that's the reason why only lesser than 10 questions we will be dealing with each and every video. Okay, so this international relations answer writing skill also will be increasing for you. Science and technology we will be covering under this. And especially in current affairs, there are many subtopics, as you know, like important appointments, important summits, appointments, summits, and many other dates, days, and as well as the important personalities, everything we are going to cover. Overall, all the concepts which are relating to the subject matter also, which is there in the current affairs, that will be covered. Okay. The first subject or the first topic that we are going to deal, it's going to be about the geography. Okay, geography questions we will be dealing in this particular video. In my next video, I'll change the topic and then I will be discussing about the multiple choice question. Among the following, which planet takes maximum revolution, time for the revolution around the sun? So here they won't ask you with regarding to the arrangements. My very elegant mother just showed us 9 planets. So that's the school days, right? Here they will be asking for one revolution, which has the maximum time taken, which planet? Here the answer is Jupiter. Just remember that whatever the options that has been given, that has to be taken into consideration. For example, here under this one, if you see that Neptune has most or takes the maximum time to revolve around the sun, isn't it? But here in this particular question, they have asked only 4, Earth, Jupiter, Venus and Jupiter. Okay, so in this answer would be Jupiter. Okay, if at all they would have given Saturn or Uranus, then it would have been Uranus. Okay. So while selecting the answer, you have to be very careful. So the answer for the question is Jupiter. Hope the explanation is very clear. It's 365.26 days. It's called as one Earth year. 365.26 days, it's called as one Earth year. In the bracket, they have given 0.2 years, 0.6 years, or 29.5 years. It's the meaning of one Earth year equals to 1 year in that particular planet. Okay. So consider to be 29.5 years means 1 earth year equals to 365.26 days. Hope the explanation is clear. Let's move on to the next one. That's about the question relating to Caspian Sea. Which of the following countries does not border the Caspian Sea? Caspian Sea, it is there in Asia and it is a landlocked water body. It's a landlocked water body. And most of the time, the question will be asked with regarding to the countries which are actually bordering this particular Caspian Sea. Armenia is the answer for this one. Let me take you to the Caspian Sea. Let's go to Caspian Sea right now in the map, not in reality. If it is possible, like, you know, in the life, we will go and visit once. Okay, Caspian Sea, in the answer, you see that, like, you know, Armenia is there. In the map, you should be aware that which are all the countries that are bordering the Caspian Sea. Here, if you see the map, it clearly says that Azerbaijan, Turkmenistan, and Kazakhstan, yes, Kazakhstan, as well as the Armenia is not there. Can you see the Armenia? Armenia, it is away from Caspian Sea, whereas Azerbaijan, Turkmenistan, and Kazakhstan is bordering. Now, let's learn what are all the countries that are bordering the Caspian Sea. First one is Russia, second one is Azerbaijan, third is Iran, fourth is Turkmenistan, fifth is Uzbekistan, and sixth is Kazakhstan. So, it's like, you know, in the direction of, like, you know, top to the bottom, it is like R A I T U and K, isn't it? It says right UK, otherwise right UK, right UK. You can make it as a mind map, right UK, R A I T U K. Okay, it's not R-I-G-H-T, right? It is R-A-I-T, right? U-K, fine? So, the next question about geography is about the thermal power plant. These are all the static GKs which I have given in this particular video. This is the first video that I am making so that, like, you know, it gives you the clarity of the questions, how they can ask and how you have to learn the concepts. In this question, the answer is Jharkhand. Bokaro is located in Jharkhand, the thermal power plant. What is the thermal power plant explains about? Thermal power plant is the largest source of power in India. There are different types of thermal power plants based on the fuel based generate the steam such as coal, gas and diesel. What are the types of the thermal power plant? The first one is coal, gas and diesel. The maximum thermal power plants uses the coal. That maximum number is 85%. Around 85% thermal power plants uses the coal to produce the electricity. And then the percentage of the electricity that has been used in India, which is produced by thermal power plant, is 65%. Okay. Hope the doubt is clear. So, the next important point which I'll be explaining to you is once the question answer is been learnt, okay, and the one more point here, it is actually it is located near the rivers, especially these thermal power plants, especially it will be located near the rivers. Whether you can pass this video and then write down or make a note of it, but you have to be clear with which thermal power station or thermal power point plant it's situated in which place, which particular state. Because somewhere in the news, you will be seeing that, you will be missed out. But if you know the static GK, one or the other way, you can answer the question very easily. Okay. So in this Vindhyachala TPS, it is the first thermal power station which produces the maximum electricity in India. And Mundra thermal power station, which is there in Kutch, Gujarat, that is second place. Okay. Sipat TPS, it's there in Chhattisgarh, and as well as Korba Super thermal power station, it is there in Chhattisgarh. Okay. So the next one is Jharsuguda TPS, that is there in Odisha. Tiroda, it is there in Maharashtra. The next one, just pause it and then make a note of it, okay? Keep it in one place so that you can refer it easily and prepare for your further examinations. You need not keep on reading and finding out somewhere. Keep a record of it. Anpara TPS, it is there in Uttar Pradesh. Baruni, see Bihar, okay? Bellari, it is there in Karnataka. Durgapura, just remember Durgapura, Durga Puja, it is done in usually main Durga Puja we can be find in West Bengal. So Durgapura power plant, thermal power plant is found in West Bengal. Sikka TPS, it is there in Gujarat. Okay, Sikka, don't confused with Punjab, it is there in Gujarat. Okay, sometimes mind mapping works, sometimes it goes wrong. So you have to be very careful about it. Satpura TPS, Madhya Pradesh. Singrauli, the TPS, that is a thermal power station, it is there in Uttar Pradesh. And these are all the very important thermal power stations that you have to have the idea about it, okay? The next question, it is about the Gandhi Sagar Dam. It is a part of which of the following? River disputes or river treaties, disputes between two states. One particular river will be there which will be disputed among two. Okay, the projects will be there which will be helpful for two or more states. This particular question, it is about the project. Okay, water treaty are very important and river disputes are very important. So, you have to have the clarity with all these concepts. Okay, Gandhi Sagar Dam is a part of which of the following? Chambal project. So, in the coming slides, you will be seeing all the important river projects which are very much useful to which particular states. From there, you have to pause. Mind my words that until the end of the video, if you watch, you will be getting benefit. Otherwise, you are going to lose many of the important topics, important points. Chambal Valley project, it is situated in between, this Chambal Valley project, it helps two states. Those are Madhya Pradesh and as well as Rajasthan. Okay. So, this is about it. And it started in the year 1954. Madhya Pradesh, Rajasthan. How do you remember Chambal? MP Raja went to Chambal. So, just make a story of it. So that it makes you to keep inside your mind very easily to recall that. Okay. MP Raja went to Chambal. That is there in Chhattisgarh, 1960. Okay. So, this is about the last question, the answer and the clarity for that one. Hope it is very clear. If it is not clear, give the comment if you have any doubts with regarding to that one. Okay. Just have the two-way communication rather being one-way flowing the information and the doubts stays there itself. See, these are all the river projects and related states. Which state is getting help or the benefits from the rivers and their projects? Bansagar project, which is there on Son. And the next one is Bias project. It's very important. It is there in North. You can guesswork, you can do it. Bakra Nangal project, it is there in Satluj. Satluj, Bias, all these are the important tributaries of Indus River. If you know Indus River very well, then it's easy for you to know all these projects. Fine. Bhima project, it is there in Maharashtra, not in Karnataka. Bhima River, don't get confused with the border states. Only one state is getting benefit from Bhima, that is Maharashtra. Chambal project, Chambal, that is Madhya Pradesh and Rajasthan. Dulhasti, it is in Chenab. Chenab again, it is there in Chenab, Jammu and Kashmir. It is a part of Indus River. Okay, these are all the things that you have to be very clear. Okay, the next one is Durga Barrage. Durga Barrage project, that is about Damodar, West Bengal. Durga, I told you, Durga, remember with West Bengal and Damodar. All Durgas comes in West Bengal. Most of the, rather saying all and only, these terms are very important, right? So, few of them or most of them comes in West Bengal. Farakka Barrage, you know it, on Ganga, that's about West Bengal. Then Ganga Sagar project, this is the MCQ that we have dealt just before explanation. It's on Chambal River. Okay. So the next one is about the Ghataprabha River. Ghataprabha River, it is there in Karnataka. Malaprabha comes. Ghataprabha, Malaprabha. Prabhas are there in Karnataka. Not Prabha, which is there in Prabhas. Don't think about the Prabhas hero, okay? This is about the Ghataprabha project, okay? Irakkudu project, that's there on the Mahanadi River, which is benefited by Orissa people. Kerala, Idukki River, Idukki project, which is there on Periyar River. This year, it was related to flood. So, be very careful and learn the concepts with regarding to the projects, rivers, important rivers in Kerala. Okay. The next one is about the Indira Gandhi Canal project. Pause the video, learn that. It will be easy for you to recall it. Mind map, do the mind mapping. Okay. Sutlej River, it's easy because Sutlej, it's the tributary of Indus. Again, it comes in the northern place, so Rajasthan, Punjab and Haryana. Okay. Kunda, Kunda project, it is there on Kunda River, which is there in Tamil Nadu. Kunda, just imagine, like, you know, just give some name. Kosi River, which is benefited by Bihar and as well as Nepal. Okay. So the next one is Jawahar Sagar project, Jayakwadi project, etc. The next one is here you can see a list of most of the rivers and their projects, like, you know, Odisha, which is about the Mahanadi Delta. Then again, I told you before, it's about Malaprabha and Ghataprabha. Prabha, Prabhas. Prabhas, two Prabhas are also there in Karnataka only, not in Andhra Pradesh or Telangana. Remember that. Vyas project, Vyas River, which is having actually Mandi project. It is there in Himachal. Just think that Vyasa wrote Bharata where? In Himachal Pradesh. Like that. Okay. So the next one is about Mayurshki project, which is there in West Bengal. Minimata Bhangu, Hasdo River. Hasdo project, it is on Bhangu River, Madhya Pradesh. Muchkund project, which is there on Muchkund River, which is between Odisha and Andhra Pradesh. That's benefit shared between these two states. Nagarjuna Sagara, Nagarjuna, who is an actor in Andhra Pradesh. It's very easy to remember Andhra Pradesh, but river is very, very important. Think that it is Krishna River. Okay. The next one is about the later on informations with regarding to the states and as well as the rivers. These are all very important. Please do map, mind mapping, you do it. As I told you before, the way I do the mind mapping, it's totally different the way you do it, because the approaches will be totally different. If you make your own story, it will be easy, very easy to do these 3 to 4 slides in 5 minutes. Just keep remembering that one and then, like, you know, you make it. This Chambal, Ravi, Rihan, the Chenab, these are all the kind of, like, you know, Indus tributaries. Tributaries are important, places are important of the river and as well as the main river. So it will be easy for you to analyze the things, okay? So this is about the Panama Canal, that is Panama, Gujarat. That's not about the Panama Canal, which is there in between North America and South America. Okay, don't get confusion with that. Vyas, we learned before. And Uri Power Project, which is there in Jammu and Kashmir. Uri, not the surgical strike. This Uri, it is about the power project, which is there in Jammu and Kashmir. Belongs to Jhelum River. This is a very important map pointing in every geography MCQs videos. I'll be explaining to you finally one particular map, that's a particular country or particular continent, ocean, anything. Okay, today we are going to talk about the geographic regions affecting the biodiversity, the Trans-Himalayans in the top, and west. Then there comes about the borders. Just see the borders here. Sri Lanka, Myanmar, there it is Bangladesh, Bhutan, Nepal, Tibet, Pakistan, there it is China and Afghanistan. So bordering countries of India is also very important. Okay, who are all our friends and who are all our foes, very important to know about it. Next comes the desert area, which is there in the Rajasthan place, a semi-arid Gangetic Plain. Gangetic Plain, it's the river. Okay, seven sister states, northeast considered to be as seven sister states, and this particular area, it is called as finger area. If you see that, this is actually looks like thumb, right? So this thumb, it is called as finger area, which is actually Sikkim. Okay. So the next one, it is about the Konkan coast and Koramandala coast. Then comes Malabar coast. Malabar coast completely, it is there with Kerala itself. It's not shared with any other this thing, but a little part of it, it's shared with Karnataka. Deccan Plateau, Central Highlands. Okay. Here in the western part comes the Arabian Sea. Okay, this mouth of Ganga, you can see, right? It's not only the mouth of Ganga, it is also mouth of Brahmaputra river. When I'll be explaining the videos about the rivers and their tributaries, I'll be giving you the ideas about the deltas and as well as with regarding to the origin of that particular river. Okay, so about this, it's very important. The later on, the points within this particular map which we have missed, yes, Arabian Sea, it is there in the western part, and the Bay of Bengal, it is there in the eastern part. This is actually known to all the students from their childhood itself. Okay, so these are all the important map points in this particular map, and the very important is subscribe and like the video. If you subscribe the channel, then only you will be getting very important videos, right? So I'll be making some other videos which are very important for your examination point of view. Please do comment and share your opinion, or your valuable comments, actually it's required. Thank you so much.